Dear students, in today's lecture, let's make an attempt to know about anatomy of silk moth, Bombyx mori. The adult stage of silkworms are called silk moths. When the silkworm pupa reaches the final stage of its development, the moth is ready within the pupal skin, which is subsequently shed and moth emerges. The body of the moth is divisible into head, thorax and abdomen and is covered all over with minute scales. It has three pairs of thoracic legs and one pair of wings, each of meso and metathoracic segments. The male and female moths can be easily differentiated by the size of the abdomen and antennae, color of the body and wings, behavior, etc. Both the external genitalia and the reproductive organs show significant differences in the two sexes. The antennae are prominent and serrate. Two large compound eyes are located below the bases of the antennae. In normal silk moths, the compound eyes are black in color, though they may be red or white in mutants. The eye color is due to some pigment that occurs in the eggs. It is tryptophan metabolite. The pigment of the skin of yellow silkworms is attributed to xanthopterin B. The mouth parts are located in between the two compound eyes and include the labrum, maxillae, labium and mandibles. The maxillae are the most prominent of the mouth parts. They are large, white and tubular in shape and have many sensory papillae on the surface. The silk moth has a pair of compound eyes, the surface of which shows a large number of minute hexagonal omnitidae arranged like a honeycomb. The structure of a single omnitidium resembles that of ocellus of the larva. The surface of each omnitidium has a cornea under which there is a crystalline cone. Antennae are the most important sensory organs of moth. They are strong olfactory sense organs. Each antennae is composed of several segments. The number of segments is usually 30 to 40, but varies according to the strain of the silkworm. Antennal segments also larger in univoltines than in bivoltine 1 moths. The size of the antennae varies considerably in the sexes, being larger in the male than in the female. The thorax of the silk moth is composed of three segments, namely prothorax, mesothorax and metathorax. All the segments are covered with hard chitinous sclerites. Of the three segments, prothorax and metathorax are smaller and the mesothorax is the largest. Each of the thoracic segments bears a pair of legs. The thorax has two pairs of wings, forewings and hind wings. The forewings are larger, nearly triangular in shape and are attached to the mesothorax. The hind wings are smaller and are attached to the metathorax. The entire surface of the wings is covered with fine scales. The wings have brown color veins and transparent wing membrane. Abdomen is extremely simple and each segment is made up of a pair of thin chitinous sclerites. The posterior end of the abdomen differs in male and female on account of the genitalia. The abdomen of the male has 8 segments, whereas that of the female has only 7 visible segments. The abdomen bears 7 pairs of spiracles. The visceral organs are partially hidden by the fat body in the abdomen and muscles in the thorax, which are extensively developed. The organs that can be identified are, number 1, heart. It is mid-dorsal in position and is restricted to the abdomen and visible only when opened laterally. Number 2, alimentary canal. This is very thin and non-functional. The sucking stomach and rectal sac are the two structures which are clearly seen and have no corresponding structures in the larva. Number 3, Malpighian tubules. There are 3 pairs of Malpighian tubules. As the gut itself is thin, Malpighian tubules are difficult to be identified. Number 4, tracheal bushes. These are less prominent, but trachea are well developed. Number 5, silk gland. These are totally absent. Number 6, nerve cord. This is visible only in the abdomen and has only 4 ganglia. Thoracic ganglia are hidden by muscles. Number 7, reproductive organs. The large ovaries fill the entire body cavity of the female. The testes are compact and located in the 5th abdominal segment in male. Number 8, fat body. The entire body cavity of the virgin female and male is filled with fat body. After oviposition, the amount of fat body decreases in the female. Digestive system of silk moth. Once the silkworm attains the maturity and stop feeding on mulberry leaves, their digestive system begins to undergo tremendous changes during pupation. The foregut becomes narrow and long, and posterior end of the esophagus forms a thin membranous sectorial crop. It is filled with a weak alkaline colorless fluid. At the time of emerging from the cocoon, the moth regurgitates this fluid to moisten the cocoon shell. It makes a hole in the cocoon and comes out of it. The midgut has a constriction and many vertical striations. It is elliptical in shape and yellow brown in color. The midgut is represented by the sucking stomach and the tubular stomach. Sucking stomach is a diverticulum arising from the esophagus and connected to it by the tubular stomach. The hindgut follows the sucking stomach. From the rectum arises a rectal sac. A pair of salivary glands open into the esophagus. 3 pairs of Malpighian tubules open into the hindgut. The alimentary canal has also digestive functions. The alimentary canal of the newly formed moth is presumed to secrete the alkaline eclosion fluid, which digests the cocoon for the emergence of the moth. This is an example of extra intestinal digestion. The secretion contains a protease which attacks the sericin of the cocoon, thereby rendering it weak and easy to break during eclosion. The other function performed by the alimentary canal is the storage of air swallowed by the newly emerged moth for distending its body wings. The hindgut is made up of long coiled intestine and colon of more or less the same diameter. The rectum is large and has a rectal sac at its anterior end. The rectal sac is usually filled with a brown colored fluid. However, in the strains with white eggs and white eyes, the fluid in the rectal sac is whitish, since the fluid in the rectal sac contains many substances. While in the larva, the uric acid is mostly contained in the epidermal cells. In the case of pupa, it is chiefly stored in the fat body of the pupa, is shifted to the rectal sac of the moth. As the content of the rectal sac is usually excreted after the moth emerges from the cocoon, it is popularly called moth urine. The moths of the normal silkworm produce brown urine, but those having white eyes and white eggs produce white urine. Circulatory system of silk moth. Blood freely baths the organs in the viscera of the larva and the adult, and hence the body cavity is a hemocele. blood vascular system is of the open type as it circulates in open channels as well as in closed vessels. The dorsal blood vessel of the adult is shorter and is present in the abdomen above the alimentary canal. It extends upwards directly as a loop called aortal chamber and proceeds to the thorax and is extended as aorta. The aorta ends in a frontal sac. Arteries arise from it, supply the antenna, eye and maxilla. The antennal vessel has a pump at its base. 7 pairs of alar muscles attach to the heart to the body wall. Malpighiae first observed reversal of heart in silkworm. It begins about 48 hours before pupation and continues at intervals until the death of the adult. The reversal of beating and reversal of blood flow is probably related to the oxygen supply of the two ends of the heart. The posterior region of the heart has a better tracheal supply than the anterior end. This probably controls the direction of the contraction of the heart and the direction of the blood flow in turn. If the posterior spiracles area occluded as that the oxygen supply is reduced, the direction of the heartbeat is reversed as the anterior part has no more oxygen supply. Excretory system of silk moth. As in the larva, there are 3 pairs of Malpighian tubules. The tubules of each side unite and open by a common duct into the hind gut. The newly emerged moths secrete a liquid urine uncontaminated by digestive wastes. This represents uric acid accumulated during the pupal period. The function of the Malpighian tubule in the adult is not clear. Regulation of calcium content of the hemolymph appears to be principal function of the pupal midgut of Bombyx mori. Calcium appears in the cells as granules which are subsequently discharged into the lumen. Respiratory system of silk moth. The functional spiracles are only 6 pairs and they are located on the lateral sides of the first 6 abdominal segments. The tracheal bushes are less prominent than in the larva. The longitudinal and transverse tracheal trunks are present as in the larva. The thorax is extensively supplied with tracheal network to supply oxygen to the wing and leg muscles. Muscular system of silk moth. Compared to the larva, the muscles in the head of the silk moth are greatly reduced, but those in the antenna are very large. The muscles in the thorax are very complicated, but those in the abdomen are very simple. The copulatory organs at the end of the abdomen have special muscles and they differ in the male and the female. Nervous system of silk moth. The central nervous system of the adult differs from that of the larvae. The brain and the subesophageal ganglion are used to form a mass around the slender esophagus. The brain and the subpharyngeal ganglia are very large in size. Their interconnectives are so short that the two almost appear to be single fused structure. Among the nerves emerging from the brain, the optic nerve is largest, followed by a thick antennary nerve, whereas they are absent in the larva. There are 3 thoracic ganglia and 4 abdominal ganglia. 3 to 5 ganglia located in the thorax and the interganglionic connectives are very short. The 3 pairs of ganglia therefore lie close to one another. In the abdomen, the 6th pair of ganglia is very close to the 5th pair and cannot be easily differentiated externally. The 7th pair of ganglia has degenerated. The last 3 ganglia are fused and appear as one single elongated ganglionic mass. The compound eyes are the optic organs in place of simple oculi of the larva. The antennae are larger and bipectinate. Reproductive system of silk moth. Female moth. The cuticle of the 8th abdominal segment is produced into two serrate lobes which helps in copulation. The 8th abdominal tergite is medially narrow but laterally broadened to form dark brown chitinous lobes. The right and left lobes bear fine bristles and their edges are produced into fine dentate. The copulatory aperture lies medially between the serrate lobes and the 7th abdominal sternite. The 9th and 10th abdominal tergites bear large tubercular genital papillae. The female possesses alluring glands which produce a sex pheromone to attract the male. This pheromone is characteristic of lepidopterous insects and related types occur in related species. Depending upon the silkworm race, its capacity to attract the male differs. In the internal reproductive organs of the female moth, the most important part is a pair of ovaries, one on either side. Each ovary has four strings of ovarian tubes or ovarioles occupying the entire abdominal cavity. Therefore, each moth has 8 ovarioles in total. On each side of the ovariole, at the proximal ends are connected by a terminal filament. The ovarioles are covered by a sheath which has muscle fibers. The ovarioles are polytrophic. In each ovariole, there is a succession of nutritive cells surrounding an egg cell which they nourish. Distally, the four ovarioles on either side, that is one set on the right and other on the left, join to form lateral oviducts. The two lateral oviducts unites to form a common oviduct which opens to the exterior by the female genital pore or vagina. The genital pore is associated with receptaculum seminus or spermatheca, bursa copulatrix and a pair of accessory glands. Arising from the junction of two oviducts is a sac-like structure called bursa copulatrix. This opens to the exterior by the opening called ostium bursae. The male transfers the spermatophores through the ostium bursae to the bursa copulatrix, from the where they are transferred to the common oviduct by the seminal duct. A sac-like spermatheca opening into the common oviducts serves to store the sperms receiving through copulation. The secretion of accessory glands is sticky and during oviposition it helps in the eggs adhering to the substratum. There are certain genetical lines of silkworms which produce non-sticking eggs. This is because the accessory glands of these silk moths are highly degenerated. A female Bombyx mori lays all her eggs within 24 hours of mating, whereas a virgin female retains most of the eggs for some days. Bombyx mori usually lays eggs in a single layer close together. If the trichoid mechanoreceptors on the anal papillae are destroyed, the eggs are laid in clusters. Tendency for sporadic parthenogenesis varies in the different races. In certain strains, there is an inherited tendency to lay binucleate ova and this is associated with gynandromorphism. The male moth, the external reproductive organs, that is genitalia or copulatory glands of the male silk moth are quite complicated. They are composed of an adygous large claspers on the two sides of the adygous, saccus extending forward from the base of the claspers. Scorpium on the 10th abdominal segment and an uncus as an accessory tergal structures of the same segment. Among the internal reproductive organs, there are a pair of testes located dorsolaterally in the 5th abdominal segment on either side of the ventral nerve cord, and a pair of vasa differentia arising from them. Each testis is formed by the number of seminiferous tubules. Small proximal parts of vasa differentia are called vasa efferentia. The vasa efferentia of each side unite to form the vasa deferens. The two vasa differentia have each an enlarged ampulla at the discal end and open into the enlarged seminal vesicles situated in the middle. The vasa deferens on either side has an enlarged part called the seminal vesicles connected to the ejaculatory vesicle. From the seminal vesicle arises the ejaculatory duct opening into the male genitalis, the edigas. The vasa efferentia and vasa differentia secretes a fluid to provide motility to spermatozoa for a single ejaculation. A pair of accessory glands open by a common duct into the seminal vesicles. The lower part of accessory glands secretes a milky white fluid. The secretion of accessory glands serve to pack the sperms in a membranous sac to form the spermatophores. Since this fluid is ejaculated later than the spermatozoa, it is considered to provide nourishment to the spermatozoa and trigger their movement. The ejaculatory duct consists of three parts, upper, middle, and lower parts. Each part has its own function, which differs from that of the another. The fluid secreted by the upper part is transparent and highly viscous. It produces spermatophores at a later stage. The fluid produced by the middle part is granular, opaque, and white. It segregates the fluids produced by the upper and lower parts. After ejaculation, the white mass adhering to the anterior part of the spermatophore is produced by this part. The secretion produced by the lower part is transparent and slightly viscous. It enhances the motility of spermatozoa. Summary: the adult stage of silkworms are called silk moths. The male and female moths can be easily differentiated by the size of the abdomen and antennae, color of the body and wings, behavior, etc. Antennae are the most important sensory organs of the moth. Each antennae is composed of several segments. Antennal segments also larger in univoltines than in bivoltine moths. Each of the thoracic segments bear a pair of legs. The thorax has two pairs of wings, forewings and hind wings. The wings have brown colored veins and transparent wings membrane. The abdomen of the male has 8 segments, whereas that of male has only 7 visible segments. The abdomen bears 7 pairs of spiracles. A pair of salivary gland open into the esophagus. A rectal sac is usually filled with a brown colored fluid. However, in the strain with white eggs and white eyes, the fluid in the rectal sac is whitish. The moth of the normal silkworm produce brown urine, but those having white eyes and white eggs produce white urine. Blood freely baths the organs in the viscera of the larva and the adult, and hence the body cavity is a hemocele. Blood vascular system is of the open type, as it circulates in open channels as well as in closed vessels. The seventh pair of ganglia has degenerated. The antennae are larger and bipectinate. Female moth, the cuticle of the eighth abdominal segment is produced into serrate lobes, which helps in copulation. In the internal reproductive organs of the female moth, the most important part is a pair of ovaries, one on either side. Male moth, the external reproductive organs, genitalia or copulatory glands of the male silkworm are quite complicated. Small proximal parts of the vasa differentia are called vasa efferentia. The vasa efferentia of each side unite to form the vasa deferens. The lower part of the accessory glands secretes a milky white fluid. The copulatory duct consists of three parts, upper, middle and lower parts. With this, we come to the end of the chapter, Anatomy of Silk Moths, Bombyx mori. Thank you.